We will now conduct a foil and head test. Foil and head test is typically done for fine-grained material like soil that has very low permeability. We have already prepared our sample here. It's in this mold. The sample is clay. We have saturated it for a few days. You will see that water comes out of the soil, out of the sample. And we know that there is a steady flow through the sample. You will see that this mold is connected to the manometer right on the top. There are three types of manometer we have for this test. The one on the left-hand side has a diameter of 10 millimeters. The one in the middle has a diameter of 6 millimeters. And the one on the right has a diameter of 4 millimeters. The way we're going to perform this test, we will connect each of the manometers to allow water in the manometer to go down and flow through the sample. We need to measure how much water will flow through the sample over a period of time. We're going to start with the one on the left-hand side, the largest one. I'm going to use the timer, and I'm going to now open this manometer so that it's connected to the sample in the mold. What we're going to do is we're going to wait until the water level hits the value of 60, and then we'll wait until it goes all the way down to 50 and measure the time. So water level is here. It's at level of 60. I start the timer. You can also see that water comes out of the sample. There is a constant and steady flow through the sample. You can see that the water flows very slowly because we deal with clay. The water level is still going down. It's almost there. Stop. It takes 2 minutes, 32 seconds for water to flow in this manometer from the level of 60 centimeters to 50 centimeters. Now we can close it. And we repeat this test. But now we're going to use the manometer in the middle with a diameter of 6 millimeters. So I'm going to slowly open it and then start the time. So again, we're going to wait when the water flow drops from 60, level drops from 60 to 50. You see that now the water flows a little bit faster because the diameter is smaller. It's the head at the level of 50. Stop. It takes 55 seconds. We're going to close this manometer. Reset the timer. And now we will repeat this test. And we used the manometer on the right-hand side. In this case, the water will flow even faster, because the size of this manometer is smaller. I'm going to open it and see how it goes first. I will start when it reaches 50. I set it now. Stop. In this case, we also have a drop of water heads equal of 10 centimeters, but it took only 38 seconds. Now we're going to use this data to calculate the coefficient of permeability of the soil.